This is Ham Nation, episode number 74, November 21st, 2012. Tower safety and coaxial dipoles. Good evening, everybody. It's that time again. It's time for Ham Nation. So all of the antennas should be up, and everybody
should.
We had a club meeting last night in New York, and he was there. In fact, I'm still playing around with my balloons. You remember the balloons to show you how your dipole worked? And for all of you who didn't see this, this is pretty cool, by the way. This is the way your dipole works. If you put up a dipole, here's the dipole. This is what happens to the pattern. It goes this way, pretty equal. If you put up some type of an array, a phased array or a beam, this is what happens. A lot of the power is going to be going that direction. And if you rotate it, it goes that direction and not a whole lot that way. So you don't waste your energy. Of course, if you just stick up an old omnidirectional, hello, it goes everywhere. So anyway, I have fun with my balloons. And sometimes Sarah says, are you in there making dogs? But it's a really good lesson about how antennas work, because it's hard for us to talk about it. But when you see
Let's turn to another thing about coaxial antennas.
You know, I get so many emails, and I love them. I love them. I try to answer all of them, phone calls, and I talk to a lot of you on the air, and you've been wanting to know more about this coaxial antenna thing we're doing. It's not a mystery. It's an incredible antenna that's been around since the late 30s that MIT actually designed it to work for the radar system with the government during the war. But let's take a look at some of the things that is going on with the coaxial dipole. So Alex, bring up a couple of them. There's a diagram of it, and even have it spelled out in different frequencies. But you'll notice that's a piece of coax. It's RG58U, the old kind, the old milky kind. It's got to be a 0.66 velocity. And you split the shield, and you tie it off at the end. And that center section is very, very difficult to hang in the air. So they're weak at that point. So you got to really make sure that you have good support in that center area, because just those two little pieces of the shield is holding it. The IAC people have got it together. They did a mold on their center insulator, and it's vacuum mold. It's really cool. And this works, and I've got one up here in Illinois. It's been there for gosh darn, I don't know how long. It's been over 15 years, and it works great, and it's never come apart. And there's a picture, if you can see it, of just a single dipole, the coaxial dipole. But you see, I have a piece of rope. I use 5/8 Dacron, black Dacron, so the sun doesn't get to it. And I wire tie that rope and the antenna together, and then down comes the coax feed. I use an irrigation valve cover, and that gets it out of the ground, and you can bury the cable then. That works really good. And then up through the antenna, and the antenna is supported by what we call a messenger line, and then we wire tie it about every foot so that center insulator doesn't have to do all the work. That's where the tough part is. That works great. Now, here is the two phased array. So you don't have to have telephone poles. You don't have to do all that. You can take two wire antennas, but they have to be 64 foot apart. That was all well spilled out in the part back on program 63 and 65 about that. But that's how I first put them up, and they worked great. They were about 30 foot above the ground and 64 foot apart. There's the diagram of them. And that phasing line is switched in and out. And you saw from my balloon a while ago, when you have your lead coming from the transmitter going right to the director, away it goes. And the reflector is delayed 43 foot. And so it makes that signal directional. Flip it the other way, it's going to go the other direction. And it works so good, and it's so easy to do. I can't tell you how incredible 20 dB on 75 meters and 40 meters is. I did a pair of these for 40 meters. So that's the phased array. And there it is without the telephone poles. You don't need all that. I just wanted to get them up higher. And if you recognize the trees and stuff, that's you see where the telephone poles will go. And that's what we did. After I had them up several months, I said, boy, I need to get them higher. So that's what I did. And that works terrific. Coaxial dipoles and in a phased array. Now, in between those, you can see that that lead that goes from pole to pole up at 33 feet. That's the 40-meter array, a 40-meter phased array. They're 33 foot apart, 33 feet high. Works great. There's all three coaxial dipoles that are omnis. There's a 160, there's 75, and there's 40 meters. And just gives us a lot of possibilities of capturing that signal as it comes down out of the ionosphere, because you never know where it's going to be. So this allows us to do that. So with those antennas, it just makes operating so much fun. 7-3, everybody, from the center of United States, Illinois tonight, not Missouri. This is K9 EID and all the Ham Nation crew. We'll talk to you next week right here. Very, very happy Thanksgiving. We all have a lot to be thankful for.